Alright, so there's pin number 35, the top one there. That white wire there. And the other white wire right beside it, that one's pin 36. It goes to the lower connection there. Pin 35 is the pulse width modulation. You want to check your monitor stats just to make sure it's, don't just go by this without double checking your monitor. Make sure you get to figure out which one's pulse width modulation. It'll probably be the same, but this is a 40 pin. For 40 pin, that's the way it seems to be for most monitors. But again, double check yours. And then go down. And they're both connected. They're both connected to the same output there. And that is why you cannot adjust the brightness. And even if you connected the proper one, there's that center one there, where it really supposed to be, brightness is still not going to work because those kits are fake. When it comes to brightness, the kits are bright, they're not real. Also, be very careful when taking these. If you take these off, those pins break. Those pins bend very easily. So, what I've done is I've marked the proper wire here. The white wire, you probably can't see it in the camera. But anyway, I put some black marks with a marker. Well, there it is. It's black and white. Put a little black marks every so often. That's the pulse width modulation line. It's all white, but I just put the marker there. So I'm going to cut that wire and then put a pulse width modulation and adjustment in there so I can adjust brightness manually. Just by simply turning a little knob, I can get whatever brightness level I want. So here's the pulse width module that I'll be using. This is one of them. I've got several of them. This one I'm currently using on a amp load tester that I've made. But the same principle. Normally your power comes in here. You got your negative and your positive, and then power comes out here, negative, positive. But what I'm doing is I'm putting the negative positive on the input, and then the output is right here, which hooks up to the other side. So to use this on the screen, the same principle. You put your power in, and then you hook up to the gate of the MOSFET there, and send that signal to the screen. And then you can control your brightness on the screen. Simply turning the knob. I gotta get the computer all hooked up. I haven't decided where I'm gonna put this here on the computer. I got several of these, but this one, of course, is I'm using for this amp tester that I built. But the one I use for the screen for the computer, I haven't decided yet where I'm gonna put it on the computer, so I haven't hooked it up yet. I haven't cut the wires yet. But that's the way it works. To use it for that, you just put your power in, your 5 volts in, and then also you'll need to back right there and get this thing to focus. I don't know why this thing is being difficult. It's not wanting to focus today. There it goes. See where it says 3 to 16? You got to put a little solder blob on those two connections there. Because you're going to be putting 5 volts in. And putting 5 volts in, it's got its own 5 volt regulator. And you put 5 volts in, that's, you're going to get less than 5 volts out. So you need to, that bypasses the regulator, voltage regulator. Let's see, where's that voltage regulator at? Oh, there it is. There's the voltage regulator right there in that little corner. And that's designed to take whatever voltage you put in. Because otherwise, this is designed to handle pretty high fairly high voltages, more than the chip can handle. So I get, anyway, so you'll need to, need to bypass that. The easiest way to bypass that is to use, And that's what this is designed for. That's the purpose of this here. If you're going to 316 volts, then you just pull a solder blob, but you can't move, use more than 16 volts on it. If you're going to use more than 16 volts on this, then you would not put a solder blob on this thing. Because otherwise you'd burn up the computer chip that's on this thing. It's a simple chip. It's a 5552, I forget what it is. The name of that chip that does the timing. Anyway, that should be, those are the white wires. Oh, that just came disconnected. Okay, those are where your white wires would go. Well, one would be ground. That wouldn't be the white wire. The white, you'd have the one white wire going to the red is, and you have to put your ground, put a ground in there, and then the other white wire would come out here to your screen. It's not too difficult putting it back on, but taking it off, it's real easy to bend the pins. That's strange. Still in right. I'll figure that out now. Put that one on. A work in progress. Got to replace this replacement adapter here. Pins are all wrong on this thing. They're in like the middle, the wrong side of that. This camera is not wanting to pick it up though. Kind of like halfway in the middle, and they're on the wrong side at that. Try to push it in, it won't go in, the won't slide on the pins because those little metal pieces are in wrong. So here's a little video of this laptop that I'm building using a desktop motherboard. Still at work on getting it set up, testing, fixing bugs. So here we got the batteries, 16 batteries. We got 16.57 volts. Power goes in through here. This here is just set up, this is to prevent inrush, so I don't come use a lot of power. Hook up a power cable to make a spark. So it creates a delay and then goes into the first power, which this is probably not going to be enough. Probably have to use a more powerful one. But for low use, it's okay. Diode, battery, management charger, and discharger. Basic battery manager, BMS. This is for balancing the batteries. There's little resistors here. I plug it into there. So, after the battery part, maybe it goes from here to the ATX power supply. I got all these different power supplies for each volt. I got the 12 volts, negative 12 volts, 5 volts, 5 volts always on. This is the all good circuit. Adapter for VHS, not VHS, HDMI to the screen.